My name is Theresa Sprague, maiden name Gaines. I'm 45 years old.
My name is Manjari Sharma, and I'm 34.
And so I'm wondering, when did you realize or when did you know that photography was your calling?
When I was younger, when I went to college, I actually just thought I wanted to do food and nutrition. I just knew S&DT students who, you know, came out with food and nutrition degrees did really well. And mm-hmm. I was like, okay, you know. I remember like it was a total last minute switch, and I was like, what am I going to go into? And mm-hmm. there was a new course being offered called Visual Communications. Only one batch had graduated before me.
Yeah.
And it was Visual Communications with an emphasis in photography. All I knew was I was the one who had the little point and shoot when we went on vacations. Yeah. And I loved putting those little 1 hour photo prints into albums. And that's like the only background I had in photography.
Yeah.
In the first year, I just took pictures like as and when they were needed by my coursework. But they always ended up being like, you know, the better photographs in the class discussed. And I was yeah. like, oh, good. Like, it's great. And at the end of the year, this one teacher who I really looked up to, who basically sold me my first camera, mm-hmm. and he's no more. And I always think of him so fondly because he gave me like an achievement award at the end of the year. And it was like, oh, outstanding student in the class for as far as photography is concerned.
Yeah.
And I was like shocked. I mean, I didn't expect that. I didn't see it coming.
Yeah.
And, you know, the only thing he told me at the end of the year was like, if you didn't see this coming and you didn't really work hard this year, what if you actually start to pay attention to some of this? And I don't remember like his words. Like, I'm like, oh, wow. You know, maybe I should take this seriously. And that was the point of what everything changed. So, you know, when the time came and I was like, you know, I'm thinking I want to like pursue a degree in the U.S. because while that school was great,
yeah,
you know, there were like a lot of photography classes where we didn't have the actual camera to try things on.
Oh.
So like a photography class that's theory is like a pointless class. It took a very long time for my family to understand what I'm doing. I'm not sure if they still do, but... It didn't really matter for them to understand it, you know? That's what's cool about mom and dad. Like, they didn't really understand it as long as they knew I was happy and having fun.
17 or 18?
I was 18, yeah. Unfortunately, in India, they're like, okay, we're an affluent enough family that we can give both our children education.
Mm-hmm.
And if they don't do something amazing with it, great. But as far as the daughter is concerned, once she's 24, when she graduates, it's time to look for her for a good suitor for marriage. So not like my parents were like, oh, we have to get her married off as soon as she's out. But it was like, okay, it's not like detrimental for her to have this like huge, you know, highly paying career that supports us because she's going to get married and go to another family. And
right.
whatever she does in that family is going to be ultimately that family's decision.
Because,
I mean, a lot of women get married and then they go into the family and it's like, does that family want them to work? Does that family need them to work? My dad was like, okay, she's having fun. She's enjoying, you know, we'll see like where the road leads her.
Yeah.
But I know my dad was always, he was like, if you decide to never get married, I'm totally fine keeping you.
I was going to say, how hard was it to make the decision to leave India and come to the U.S.?
Oh, that was easy.
That part
was easy. Coming here was easy.
It wasn't scary?
No, because it was like, no, because not at all. Because like all you see of like the United States in the movies is like, oh my, look at this cool place. I mean, the West has such like, people are just like, you know, like it's glamorous. So like that's the thing is like the glamour goes away. And that's when like when you come here, you're like, oh, wow, cool, new building, new street corner, new sign, like new everything. And then like a few months down the line, you're like, you come back home and, you know, it's just you. And that part was hard. I mean, I feel like, I feel like when you're not with anyone else, then you're with yourself.
Right.
And maybe like when there's a lot of noise, you don't get to hear who you are.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're here and your family isn't, you don't have someone else deciding what you're going to eat or someone else like, you know, throwing your laundry in, you know.
Right.
It's like you have that quiet time with yourself and you get to know.
Yeah.
You know, and I feel like I did. Like, I feel like I learned to respect life and everything that went into maintaining it more after coming to the U.S.
Right.
Yeah. I would probably like standard rite of passage of any like growing,
yeah, becoming person. Your own independent person.
Yeah. But the things that were harder that I felt I got from, like, I feel like I got, like, this deeply spiritual perspective in India that, mm-hmm. you know, because you walked in and out of, like, very hard circles of life, you know, you saw, you know, you read this fantastic, you know, you went to school and then you walked out and, you know, you saw lepers on the street corner and you saw kids begging and mm-hmm. then you went home to great food, but then you also saw multiple stratas of society were crashed into each other.
Right.
And so you just had like a different respect for food and a different respect for roof over your head.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that sometimes taken for granted here?
Yeah. I do. And I my big pet peeve is food. Like, and I
know that about you.
I hate seeing food thrown.
But it is so important because do tend to think of so much in our society as being throwaway.
I wonder what Dad would think of this interview. I think it's okay. I mean, that's the only thing I would say is that my dad, like, said to me, he was like, it's okay to fail. It's not okay to not try.
Yeah, or to give up, right?
It's like, go ahead and, like, try your hand at failing, and then, you know, if you fail, then try to fail better the next time, you know? You can't not try. And that was the big thing about coming to the U.S. too. I said if I didn't do it, mm-hmm. then I'd keep wondering what it'd be like if I did.
Yeah.
And if I didn't do it, like, you wouldn't be my sister-in-law and we wouldn't be sitting here.
Right.
Meeting you was like, you helped me marry your brother. Not family was so important to me, and you were the first person I met, and that, like, made such a difference. So thank you for being my sister.
Oh, thank you for being my sister, too.
Should we just openly weep on the mic now? Because we could go there.
Is that good?
Okay.
Yeah. Great.